Amen.
Let's get a grace and peace from the Lord Jesus Christ with you all.
And with your spirit.
So I ask you to pray this day for my sister-in-law, Margaret Sullivan, and all those who are sick. Just ask God's mercy and care all in need. Lord Jesus, you.
And with your spirit.
You are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh, the splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Reading from the book of Sirach. Wisdom sings her own praises. Before her own people she proclaims her glory. In the assembly of the Most High she opens her mouth. In the presence of his hosts she declares her worth. In the midst of her people she shall be exalted. Shall be revered in the whole assembly. In the multitude of the elect, she shall be praised. Among the blessed, she shall be blessed. I spread out my branches like a tenebrae, my branches so bright and so grateful. I bud forth delights like the vine. My blossoms become fruit, fair and rich. I am the mother of fair love. Of fear, of knowledge, of holy hope. In me is all grace of way and truth and of truth. In me all hope of life and strength. Come to me, all you who yearn for me, and be filled with my fruits. And you will remember me as sweeter than honey, better to have than honeycomb. He who eats of me will hunger still. He who drinks of me will thirst for more. He who obeys me will not be put to shame. He who serves me will never fail. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. When the afflicted one called out, the Lord heard all his distress. The Lord saved me.
Bless the Lord at all times.
Taste and see how good the Lord is. Happy the one who takes refuge in the Lord. Fear the Lord, you his holy ones, for not his lacking to those who fear him.
Bless the Lord at all times.
When the just cry out, the Lord hears them. From all their distress, he saves them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit, he saves.
I will bless
the Lord at all times. Reading from the letter of Paul to the Galatians. While we were not yet of age, we were like slaves, subordinated to the elements of the world. But when the designated time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to deliver from the law those who were subject to it, so that we might receive our status, adopted, bought, sons. Proof that you are daughters and sons is the fact that God has sent forth into our hearts the spirit of his own Son, which cries out, Abba. You are no longer slaves, daughters, and sons. sons. The fact that you are such makes you heirs by God's desire. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. With your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed, a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. On arrival, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, O highly favored daughter. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." She was deeply troubled by the angel's words and wondered what this greeting meant. The angel continued, "Not fear, Mary. You have found favor with God. You shall conceive, bear a son, and give him the name Jesus. Great will be his dignity, and he will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father. He will rule house of Jacob forever, and his rule, his reign, will be without end." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My sister, one of my sisters and her husband, spent a typical summer in a small cabin, a nice little cabin at the edge of Lake Erie in Canada. In a typical summer, right about this time, I have an opportunity to visit them. I spent 3 or 4 days with them and their beautiful place. Well, this is not a typical summer, and the border is closed, so they're not even there at that place, let alone me. I feel worse for them. But it's a special place to me. They've been going there for summers, and I've been visiting them for I don't know how many years. There's always been for me an opportunity to find solitude there, to find peace. They go off to work each day, and I'm pretty much the day free to myself. And it became for me a very special, holy, a sacred place. We celebrate today a feast that's really of a building. It's called Our Lady of the Angels Chapel, the Portiuncula. Francis called it that. It's a small little place, a small portion. For Francis, it was a place that was home. It was a place that revitalized him. Not because it was beautiful. It was a very, very simple, humble chapel. It was stone, really unadorned, nothing artistically magnificent. And outside of a very small town in an insignificant place, but it was built to honor the Blessed Mother. And Francis found there a place where he was able to pray, where he felt close to God, where he felt that, by virtue of maybe of the name of this place, Our Lady of the Angels, that the angels were closer to earth in that place. It is not unusual in the scriptures or in our own lives even to find here no places where there is a liveliness of spirit, a sense of being closer to God than everywhere else. And this is particularly unusual, I suppose, for Francis, because Francis had an intuition, a powerful experience that God was everywhere. Francis repeated this all the time, that the Lord was present here, everywhere in creation. And so Francis knew this in his heart. It was what drives him, drove him, that God had sent his own Son into the world. Part of why we hear this particular reading of the Annunciation today, that God filled the world with the glory of God. So with their God present. so tenderly, this little tiny, really insignificant chapter is a curiosity. It's also, I trust, a lesson for us. And even our lives, there are places that we find we pray with the greater spirit. There are things that maybe we carry around or they adorn the walls of your home that we call us prayer. These things and these places are for us a memory of what God is doing with us, around us, for us, and with us. They're reminders, and they are just motivations that enable us to recognize that God has filled the world with His glory, so that creation proclaims the glory of God. So it deserves, it merits our respect and our care. And that God animates all the lively creatures, especially our sisters and brothers, with the living spirit of Jesus Christ. So they all require our tender care, our respect, and our love, and that we receive love from them. That we all know, that we know we are all children and creatures of God. Together as brothers and sisters. We've been named sisters and brothers by the power of God's Spirit. So we give thanks that this day we come together to in this home to recognize that indeed God is here in a sacred way. In this sacred way that God animates us, we take to our homes, places where we work, where we buy our food, encounter strangers, we encounter others in need, we encounter those who are not well. We learn that God brings us together, is with us, enables us to find peace, to find harmony, to find the love of Christ in one another.
Blessed
are you, holy God, and your witness, who give us this wine that we offer through the divine work of our human hands, and become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of the name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
We offer you the sacrifice and the praise, O Lord. We rejoice in the memory of your Son, and we pray that through this most holy exchange we may advance towards eternal redemption. We pray for Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, with you,
and with your Spirit. We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere. Give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, right and eternal God, to praise, bless, and glorify your name on this feast day of Blessed Virgin Mary, Queen of the Angels. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, without those losing the glory of her virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Christ our Lord. Through him all the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, you are the font of all holiness. Pray you send your spirit on our gifts as you send them to do fall, so that they become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. He was given up to death. He took bread and gave thanks and praise. He broke it and shared it with his disciples. He said, take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you.
This cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
We celebrate this memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer the Lord the bread of life, the chalice of his own salvation. We give you thanks. You have held us worthy to gather in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that as we share this body and blood of Christ, we might be gathered into one. Remember your church spread throughout the world. Remember to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis, our Bishop Timothy, all your humble servants. Remember to our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Pray for all those who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that today we share the life of all of your holy ones. Live forever with Mary, the blessed Virgin Mother of God, King of the Angels, and blessed Joseph, her spouse. All the saints in heaven, Francis and Claire, the apostles and martyrs who have pleased you throughout the ages, we will be heirs of eternal life, praise and glorify you forever. Through him and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed
be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
We pray, O God, for all that is evil, graciously grant us peace in our days. The help of your mercy, free us from sin, and save us from distress, as we await the blessed hope of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Since you said your apostles, I give you my peace, I give to you. Lord, we pray, see not our faithfulness, see not the sins of our faithfulness and gracious, we grant us your peace and unity, you will reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Friends, may the peace of Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
our friends at home praying together. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament, the love you above all things. Since I cannot now receive you this sacrament, come to my heart. So you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Let me remind you, when you come to communion, please don't make bow before you come forward. Once you're in your place, please stand still, your left hand out, flat. Okay? Thank you. Please kind of line up in the middle as well. This is basically between you. God in heaven, may this banquet be a benefit to us who honor the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, so that we may celebrate more worthily your Son's boundless mercy toward us, and nurture unending love for him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you this day, may God turn his face to you, and be gracious always to you. Lord, look upon you with kindness and fill your lives with peace. May God bless you, I pray, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The celebration of God's love is ended. Let's go together in peace. Love the Son of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.